So, Michelle, how are we? How are we?
I'm fine.
Two what?
Between two trains, passing in the middle. Sometimes I nearly fall down.
Because of the meal or what?
No, because...
Yeah, what comes before? That, I mean, whenever something happens, yeah, you always have to look what comes before that. What kind of thought crawls in? Yeah? Because that gives us an indication. It just doesn't do it automatically.
Everything I do, chanting, when I talk, the mask to written, very interesting, I can't do anything without
I mean, that must be a French problem. He sits in the car, falls asleep, you know, he listens, falls asleep.
And then my... It's not very sharp. It's quite good.
So then try something, you know, for a week, yeah? Just do, you know, maybe 5 or 6 hours of meditation, but in 1 hour you really, you know, you really want to be alert, yeah?
Actually, I tried everything.
Yeah, but something, you know, something is blocking you and you don't see what is blocking you. And that is what we want to get at. Yeah? What is blocking you? What kind of thought comes? Yeah? Maybe just the thought, doesn't matter. It comes from the klesa, it doesn't matter. Yeah? And then we go along the path. Yeah? But the moment we see that thought, it doesn't matter. What doesn't matter? Yeah? Then you're highly alert. Yeah? Oh, I'm with my Buddha. Yeah? When this thought comes, yeah? I cannot be with my Buddha because this thought came. Try something new to wake you up, yeah? Whatever works, yeah? Get angry.
This doesn't work since a long time. I already tried it in France, and it was just working at the beginning, but now no way.
Yeah, but then find something else, yeah? Maybe it is also some medicine that you take.
Or I take guarana also.
And maybe you stop for a while and see if this has effect.
That worse if I stop. When I stop, it's worse.
It's worse. Well, try it out again and see. Yeah, I mean just for a few days. Yeah. Otherwise, just tell yourself, Welcome, you know, if I can't get it to work, you know. Welcome, hell, here I come. Or whatever is frightening you, yeah? Well, see yourself as baby again, yeah? Mm-hmm. It's not frightening.
Well, it's for since such a long time, I don't want to come back. That doesn't frighten me anymore because I'm used to the fact that I don't want to come back.
You don't want to come back, but you're coming back. Isn't it, Alex? We all come back. And then we go through the same problems again. Maybe a little bit different. Yeah. This is something you really, as long as you're, even as a sotapanna, you come back. This is something you have to realize. If I don't get into, you know, a safe, yeah, in a safe tavern or enter the stream, you know, I will, you know, I can be thrown around in the, you know, world of samsara in any kind of the 31 realms, including the ghost realm, including the demon realm, including the hell realm, including the animal realm. Yeah, we don't know. And that sometimes, you know, gives us energy, you know, or motivation, you know, to go on. Yeah. Even if I don't want to come back, yes, we believe we don't want to become. Nobody wants really wants to come back, huh? David, you want to come back? You don't know. Well, because you don't really picture it, you know? Picture the life that you had, you know? From 1 year to 15 years or 20 years, yeah? Andrea? And then ask yourself, you know, do I want to go through the same mess again? Because that's when I come back as a human being, I will be going through this, no, there's no doubt about it.
I really think that the tiger will be here, I will fall asleep.
Yeah, you think so. I mean, and that is one of the problems, yeah? You think you're not going to be reborn, you think, you know, I mean, you're not afraid of death, you think you're not afraid of hell, but if you really bring up the memory, then fear comes up. I mean, there's probably somewhere, you know, a YouTube video where somebody is eaten or, you know, attacked by a tiger, you know, and parts of his body are torn out, you know, and look at that, you know, if that doesn't frighten you, you know, if that doesn't send a shiver through your spine, then, but...
I think she never fell asleep when she was working on the trampoline. They usually go for hours, and you always think she fell asleep. I don't know if that's a solution.
Yeah.
It's more active.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, that it's the nature of the chitta. The moment it gets calm, it falls asleep. Yeah. And there is something that we really, you know, I mean, you really want to do that. Yeah? I mean, now, when you do the meditation, yeah? Okay, before I fall asleep, you know, I want to know. So this time you just set yourself up, yeah? Be with the Buddha, be with the breath, but I want to know when I fall asleep. I want to know this. I mean, you have to put some energy in the practice, you know, otherwise, yeah? I mean, you just fall asleep and never wake up, yeah? And then where do you go? Maybe to your friends in the demon realm. Where are we coming from, huh? You weren't fasting today, so I mean, you should have known. I mean, as long as nothing is said, you know, it is Sunday, Wednesday and Friday. Was? You almost forgot. Get the power. It is the mental energy, it's not the physical energy.
Well, I even put my alarm clock at 2 o'clock in the morning, you know.
Yeah, because, I mean, you did it for so long, yeah. That's why, you know, it becomes a habit, you know. Just to fall asleep, the mind is calm, okay, fall asleep. Yeah? And then watch out, you know, in your meditation, once the mind gets calm. So what is happening?
Walking, huh?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, yes, I believe you. Yeah, yeah. But it is your disinterest, and disinterest is not the thing. Yeah, I mean, you're not just interested in anything. Yeah, when you walk. Yeah. Because you understand, you know, when you do some work, you know, even if it is very simple work, yeah, I mean, we're still distracted with the work that we are doing. So, I mean, it's much easier for us to keep with the Buddha. Yeah? Just do the work, you know, placing one stone, yeah, after the other, yeah, or putting the sand, yeah, and so on. Because it's easier, because the chitta is mostly occupied with doing the work, and the rest of the chitta is very easy, you know what I mean, to concentrate. That's why people, you know, when they climb mountains, get easily concentrated, you know, because I mean, there's a lot of activity, you know, that the chitta has to control, yeah? The body just doesn't, you know, climb on its own, yeah? And there's always, you know, there's the looks, you know, there's this, yeah? Or when they race at a high speed, yeah? I mean, they have to be concentrated, otherwise they're dead. And nobody likes to be dead, you know? When they climb, they have to be concentrated, otherwise they fall off, you know, and die, yeah? Or when they do other things, you know? I mean, that's why people love this extreme sport, because it's so easy to concentrate, but it's not meditation. You understand? This is something that you have to find out really. Yeah? What? Yeah? What gives me energy? Yeah? Then you know, I mean then sit in your meditation and do the chankram part, yeah?
And do
your chankram part, you know, I mean fit one stone after the other.
Grass.
I mean, yeah, she can beat, you know, she can beat the grass, yeah.
I can't do it.
Yeah, you can do it for a while, yeah. I mean, I don't know. I mean, really. And ask yourself, you know, I mean, what did you do 20 years ago to get good meditation?
That was completely different because that seems the practice that I had.
Yeah, but...
Before it was not like that.
Yeah, the accident, you know, makes things a little bit more difficult because of the body, yeah? But if you have understood one thing, we are not the body. So however, in whatever shape the body is, I mean, of course, you know, in the beginning it will affect the chitta, but the chitta has actually nothing to do with the body. Yeah? When the chitta is completely concentrated, the body is gone, no matter what. Yeah. And that is something, you know, I mean, we really have to tell ourselves. Yeah? It is not the body that gives us the trouble, it's the chitta that is concerned about the body that gives us the trouble.
The problem
Yeah.
To get the form of Shita. Because if you are not, if you cannot, if you are there, you cannot get the concentration.
Yeah, and that is something that you have to figure out by yourself, you know, how to make yourself so motivated that you don't, you know, that you don't lapse off, that you don't fall off sleep. Yeah, that is something that you have to do and see your arguments. It's always because of the body. That, you know, that give you the excuses not, you know, not to put so much energy. Yeah, isn't it? I mean, I see a lot of excuses, you know, coming from you because of the body. Yes, I mean, because of the body, you know, I mean, we don't have, you know, we don't have the agility anymore, yeah? But that, you know, doesn't hinder the citta, really, yeah? But the, as long as we are concerned about the body, yeah? Then, of course, you know, the moment the citta is concerned about the body, maybe it is too weak, maybe it is, you know, maybe, then we can't get our concentration straight. Yeah? Or do investigation of the body. You know, I mean, just really, you know, I mean, cut it up, you know, in the bits and pieces. Yeah? Yeah? Cut it up, you know, cut the finger, you know, cut the finger off, cut this, you know, and look at it, you know, and then cut the next finger off, look at it, throw it in front of you. Yeah? And then do this, and then do it again, and do it again, and do it again. Yeah? So to get a little bit, you know, less concerned about the body, because we are not the body. When all the parts of the body are in front of you, I mean, who is sitting there? Yeah?
It's not really the body, physical body, it's still more with the vital energy.
Yeah, but the chit has plenty of energy. I mean, of course, you know, I mean, the energy of the chitta can be sucked up in the body, yeah? And that's where we have to, you know, train the energy that is sucked up in the body and get it back to the chitta.
Because sometimes I feel that I have the energy, but it doesn't follow body.
Yeah.
Follow.
Yeah, and then look at it.
The mental energy I have, but sometimes after it doesn't follow, so much.
Yeah. But, you know, I mean, it is, the citta is the most powerful thing, yeah? I mean, it's not the car, you know, that, you know, that just doesn't go, you know, even when the driver pushes down, you know, it's a problem with the car. But the driver, you know, I mean, the driver is completely healthy. And this connection you haven't made yet. You always believe, you know, yes, of course, the body will influence the citta. And the more the citta is worried about the body, the more the influence will be. Yeah? But then you're in a catch-22 and never get out. Then you can only hope, hopefully next life I have a better body.
Because I can see very often there are things I'm not able to do.
Yeah?
But because I say, God, you can do it, and you know, I just breaks me down one step, and I do it.
Mm.
And I do that most of the time because
yeah.
I'm not able to do most of the thing I do, you know.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
For that.
Yeah. See, this you can do. Huh? But when it then comes to meditation, you suddenly are. Yeah. Okay. I mean, fine, you know, I mean, it is your life, it is your responsibility, and you will reap the results of your practice, yeah? So, I mean, find something, you know, especially get before you fall asleep, yeah? I mean, they announce it 5 minutes before they fall asleep. The kilesas will announce it, yeah? But we don't catch it. And that's why, you know, you really sit down, okay, just, you know, I just want to catch that, yeah? I'm not interested in anything else, yeah? I just want to catch these thoughts, you know, that bring me to fall asleep, yeah? More I can't help you.
When they say, oh, that's calm, can it be...
Yeah, that is the first indication, you know? Normally, when the citta is calm, it wants to fall asleep, yeah? It's an automatic, you know, I mean, we used to, I mean, otherwise, you know, I mean, that's how we you know, in the evening we lie down, our mind becomes calm, and that's how we fall asleep. Yeah. And this thing, you know, we have to really cut up. Yeah. See what is going on. Yeah. I mean, it's the first thought. It might be the first thought, or maybe there's a thought before. But when you catch this thought, you know, okay, now, let's see what is going on. Just tell yourself, okay, let's see what is going on, how the kilesas are tricking. Yeah? That brings up an awareness, that brings up more sati, yeah? And it doesn't disturb.
But when you are doing chanting, for example, yeah? There is no thought going on.
Oh, there are lots of thoughts. I mean, you will be amazed how many, yeah? I mean, ask the people who chant the Patimok for 45 minutes, how many thoughts are still going on. And I see, you know, I mean, even in the Anumodana, when I chant it, you know, when there's a thought coming up, yeah? And sometimes there is a thought coming up. I mean, I have to pull back, you know, what am I chanting, yeah? But I do see them coming up, you know, and sometimes I still can chant on, you know, but sometimes they are disturbing, and then I have to reflect, you know, where am I, yeah? With my chant. There are so many thoughts. Oh. I mean, you can think about, you know, you can chant, you know, and you can, and that is the amazing thing that we learn with chanting. You know, you can chant, you know, and the body can chant in, while you think about this and that, yeah. And only if it gets too much, you know, I mean, then you will stop because you don't know where you are.
But Timoka is going so quick that I don't know how you can even sing.
Oh, yeah.
I'm very surprised that someone can say, you know, because me, I cannot count the number of thoughts I have when I chant. I mean,
They're coming in, yeah? I mean, just the morning and the evening chanting, I mean, still, you know, they're coming in. Yeah? And that is also a training. When we do the chant, just be with the chant, yeah? And then we see, you know, with the chanting, you know, when we do the morning or evening chanting, that actually, you know, just before the end of one of the sentences, the next sentence pops up. But when we have a thought at that moment, you know, I mean, then we are stuck.
For the Patimokkhaya, when it goes smoothly, it's like this, after each rule, you
It comes, you know, I mean, it comes. You haven't even finished, you know, the last sentence and the next sentence already, you know, the beginning of the next. And then if you hop, you know, from one sentence to sentence, I mean, you're not disturbed. But if there's a thought coming at that point, then you stop. Does Tenten Richard notice these thoughts coming up while he's chanting?
He said not at the beginning. It gets less.
No.
And then it goes smoothly.
No.
Just like you said, the next line.
But what is happening when you chant, for instance, the Anumodana in the morning? Because that is just short. Well, there's lots of thoughts.
Suddenly, chanting in front of everyone.
Just chant to yourself. Just tell yourself. Chant to yourself. Yeah. Just like you do it. You practice, you know, in your kuti.
For me, in the Anumodana, because I have a bit of problem with this one, it seems that it's the feeling coming from...
Is the feeling?
Oh, no, it's going on again. But the feeling of, you know, like stress or like...
Yeah.
But there must be thought before, but I don't...
But what is the thought before?
Yeah. For me, I just see the feeling coming and all again.
Yeah, what is it? I mean, that is the key to the practice, to catch the thoughts, yeah? Not coming, yeah? Because there's a thought, you know, that is, you know, there's fear coming up, there's a thought before this fear comes up. Yeah. Yeah.
What you make if you see the thought?
What?
What change if you see the thought? Because
then you can protect yourself. Then you can negate the thought, you know, I'll just throw it out. Yeah. When the thought comes, I'm tired, and then you said, no, I'm not tired. Just simple as that, you know. I mean, you object to whatever the kilesas are presenting you. Huh? It is like, you know, you're the CEO of a company, you know, and your subordinates come and said, you know, we need to do that. And then you look at the paper and sign it and say, okay. But Then you come and look, you know, no, I'm not sustaining it, and then nothing happens.
Every time spokes?
That, yes. Yeah. I mean, that's why we try to get calm, you know, so that we can see, you know, the, no, I mean, if there's masses of thought, you don't do it, you know, you just shoot them up until they're only one coming at a time, you know, and then you can look at them, you know, and see, you know, and say no, yeah. Not interested. And sometimes you tell. Thought comes up, not interested, and it goes, instantly goes, yeah. But you have to mean it. If you're just a little interested, ah, that could be, yeah, then you're gone, yeah. It's you, you know, who decides, you know, what are kind of thought are interesting, yeah, and what are not interesting, yeah. You have to get the control back, yeah. I mean, somebody took the control, yeah. They made you asleep, you know, I mean, the chitta is constantly asleep, it just, you know, has enough power, you know, to sign all the papers that come, yeah. The kilesas, every moment they present you tables, I need to do this, I need to do that, I need, and then you're like, okay, it's me, because they suggest, it's you, yeah, it's you who want this, huh? But you see, you know, it's just a thought, you know. And that's where the power of Dhamma is coming in. The moment we realize there's a thought, you know, okay. Yeah? Just like if somebody comes and visits you, you don't want to see him, say, forget it, yeah? I'm not here. And then he has to turn his back, yeah? And it's just like with thoughts or with memories, yeah? Just tell them, I'm not interested, yeah? It will work for a while, yeah? Until they find another way. They always find some way, you know, to entice you. That's why it is important, you know, I mean, not when there are so many thoughts coming in, we are not interested in any of them, yeah? But when they come one by one by one, then we start to get interested about the contents, what they are telling us, yeah? Because they are telling us what we want, what we don't want, what we have to do, what we have to become, what the future is, what the past was, yeah? And then we have to actually, you know, stand up and say, no, I'm not like that, yeah? Or I don't want this, yeah? Who are you to tell me? That's very interesting, yeah? When a thought comes up, yeah, we are ridden by guilt, you know, and then, who are you? Who are you to tell me? Huh? Have you ever tried that? Very interesting. Because then they're startled, you know, they have no power over you, yeah? They have only the power of suggestion, yeah? And you know, from our worldly life, that the power of suggestion can be very strong, yeah? I mean, that's how advertisement works, yeah? You see a picture, you see a slogan, and you see that often, you know, and then you don't even think it is internalized, you know, and you think you need this, yeah? Or you hear something, you know, in the news, you know, you hear it over and over and over again, and then you start to believe it. Yes, that's the truth, yeah? And somebody said the more often you say something untrue, the more true it becomes, yeah? I think Goebbels used that, yeah? The power of propaganda. And the kilesas are doing the same thing. They're constantly suggesting you. Yeah? But if you say no, they have no power. Because you, with your intention, you actually have to fulfill their wish, yeah? And that is what we have to learn, you know, to see, yeah, okay. You're tired, okay, go and sleep, you know, I'm sitting. Yeah? Or you're in pain, you know, you want to get up, okay, go, yeah. But I still sit here, yeah. And that's where they start to fight, yeah. They have more weapons, not only the weapons of suggestion, yeah. They also have the weapons, you know, of pain, you know, of the body, of feeling, you know, of memories. They cannot bring these things up, yeah? But in the beginning, the important thing is, you know, to catch their intentions, their thoughts, you know? Because that's how they tell us what they were going to do. Oh, it's so calm, yeah, I want to go to sleep, yeah? And we say, just yes, whoops, we're gone. Huh? Yeah?
Sometimes, or most of the time, I think if I go to sleep, I will relax and have more.
Yeah, yeah, that's what they tell you.
I want to relax my mind,
yeah?
My heart. I go to sleep a little bit.
But
that is not.
And you see it, you know, and that's why we have.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, I mean, that's why we have to have the check, yeah? That's why I said, you know, the daily reflection gives us a check upon, you know, what the Kilesa suggests. In the beginning, we really don't know, yeah? So if you don't know what is happening, okay, then I say, okay, let's have and try it out, yeah? And then, and after, you know, after you come out from this little nap, you know, I mean, you re-evaluate and see, that wasn't worthwhile, you know, it is even worse than before. Then you do that 3 or 4 or 5 times and you re-evaluate each time and then you see, okay, that's useless, you know, I'm not going, yeah? But if you don't evaluate, yeah, I mean, we will do that, yeah, and then it becomes a habit.
I mean, he said when the mind calm, we fall asleep. But for me, all the life, when the mind not calm, I want to go to sleep to calm my mind.
Yeah, to calm your mind, because you can't do that, yeah?
I'm very constant.
Yeah, yeah. But could you go to sleep?
Yeah.
Well, that, you know, then you have the ability also to go, get to calm, yeah? Huh? Huh? Then just tell the body, okay, go to sleep, you know, but I stay awake. Something, you know, I mean, you have to find, you know, I mean, everybody, you know, has different characteristic tendencies and he has to learn how he can use it, yeah, for his own profit, yeah. And in order to learn, you know, about our habits and characteristic tendencies, I mean, we really have to do the reflection. Huh? What did I think, you know, I mean, in the morning when I woke up, what kind of thoughts or what kind of memories were in my mind, yeah? Not judging if it was good or bad, you know, and then what did I do then? Okay, I sat down to meditate. Yeah, how was the meditation, you know, I mean, okay, I was tired, yeah, and so on and so on. And then go through the whole day in order to see, you know, cause and effect, yeah. We have some sort of thoughts, you know, that will cause some sort of, you know, mood, yeah. And this is something, you know, it is not natural, you know, I mean, that's, and then we can change, you know, and if you see it's not going out well, then we can change these thoughts when they come in and say, no, I don't believe you. Always remember, you know, I mean, Goethe said it once, you know, I mean, there are two powers in my chest, yeah, the darkness and the light, and that's the same thing in Dhamma. It's called the Dhamma and the Kilesas. Yeah? And whoever has, you know, the reign over the heart can determine what the body does. Yeah? And these two powers constantly fight against each other. So in the course of meditation, we have to give the Dhamma or the light more power and more power and more power so that it can defeat the darkness. Yeah? Okay, check.
For me, Kilesa is like an angry wife.
An angry what?
Wife.
Yeah.
Call a girlfriend. You know, when you're at home,
yeah.
And you want to watch a movie and she's angry at you and she stands there and, you know, just fight you. And mm-hmm. You don't want to fight.
Yeah.
She wants it.
Mm.
So I had troubles with this, you know, and like I said the last time, I opened my eyes. So
yeah.
It was like I was going away from the house.
Yeah.
And then I came back, she wasn't there. So I had a few, you know, seconds to be on my own, and then she comes back.
Yeah.
And so I did it repeatedly,
yeah.
Until she figured me out, and then every time I came into the house, she's already there. You know, and at that time, I needed to go walk.
Uh-huh.
But now, today, was my first day when I finally managed to ignore her.
Yeah.
And then she just stops, you know, she gets tired, and that's it.
Yeah, that's the best way. Yeah. I mean, even as a wife.
Yeah. But it's hard knowing to care about you to be able to ignore her. Because, and usually, when you wife or girlfriend, you know, even if you start talking to her, it's over.
It's over. You lost.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, that's a good realization, yeah? I mean, it just, you know, I mean, we do, you use different pictures, you know? I mean, it's the same, you know, the Kilesas come up to you constantly. I mean, I call them normally necking childs, yeah? Whenever you go to a supermarket and you see a mother with a child, and then, I want this, I want this. And if he doesn't get it, you know, it cries, yeah? And because of this cry, you know, the mother gets weak, you know, and just gives it, you know, so that it gets calm, yeah? But the more, you know, the more we do that, I mean, the more the child cries, yeah? But if the mother is stern and says no, I mean, the child will cry and it will know also next time that it doesn't get it, yeah? So it will stop over the time. It will find some other ways, yeah?
Indeed. So now I'm able to ignore
her.
My mind is totally clear.
Yeah.
But now I have a physical problem. My legs after about 20 minutes, half an hour, start to go numb.
Yeah, that's okay.
But it's uncomfortable.
Yes, of course.
And I don't know what to do.
No, don't do anything. Yeah, just be careful when you get up there. Yeah, just, you know, massage your leg a little bit, you know, and move it up and down. Yeah, don't get up very quickly.
I don't think it's a meditation problem.
No.
Right leg is okay.
It is for everybody.
It's more open. Left is more closed. I cannot, you know, do.
I mean, what happens is that one of the bones is getting on the nerves. It doesn't get on the blood, you know. People think, you know, it gets on the blood, you know, and my leg will die. No. It just gets on the nerve, and the numbness is something like, you know, like the doctor, you know, giving you an injection of anesthesia. I mean, you have the same feeling. Yeah, you can't feel your leg anymore. Yeah, but the moment you move it, it comes back to life, and that is actually much worse when when it is numb. Yeah?
So I'm trying to.
No, don't forget about it.
Every time I sit to meditate, I try different position.
Yeah.
Maybe this time.
Yeah, you can try it and you will see, it is just like your wife found a new way, you know, to bother you. Yeah.
And also today, I would say for the first time in my life, I was calm.
Mm-hmm.
I never knew this feeling, you know, being totally calm and it's great.
Yeah. But now, don't look for this calmness. Just do your work, and this calmness will come again. Just remember, you ignored her, you know, and you ignored some of the numbness and the pain, and then this calmness will come. Yeah.
And I'm calm after the meditation also.
Yeah. And yes, of course. After. Yeah. I mean, that means, you know, I mean, you reach a state where really thoughts have stopped. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that is, you know, where we recharge our batteries. And if you have recharged batteries, of course, you know, after the meditation, you know, the batteries, you know, will empty slowly, yeah? And you will see it after, when you start to read or when you start to think about it. I mean, it drains the batteries very quickly, yeah? But if you still keep your buddho, you know, all the time, I mean, it still discharges the batteries, but, you know, slowly. Okay, so but remember it, and don't fall for the trick to look for this calmness. Just look, do your work, and the calmness will come. Yeah? If you don't do the work, if the calmness doesn't come, you know you don't do the work. Yeah? So, what?
It's a
I acoustically don't hear you. What is the meaning of
to enter the stream?
How to enter the stream?
You know what it means. What it means to be. What you need to
do. Oh, what it means to enter the stream. And to enter the stream is entering the stream is the stream to Nibbana, to freedom, to absolute freedom. And there are four stages. Yeah. The first is the stage of entering the stream. The second stage, yeah, this person who enters the stream is at most born 7 more lives, yeah? But he is not going down to the lower realms. He is either born as a human being or in the heaven, yeah? The next stage is the once returner, who comes only back 1 more time, the next stage is the non-returner, who has not yet finished all, yeah, but he will not be born in any kind of the central realms anymore. Yeah, he has five realms where he has to go through until he reaches Nibbana. And the last stage is, you know, Nibbana, yeah, the final stage of freedom.
And then what should I do to be...
What do you do? You know, I mean, I will explain it, you know, but maybe not today. Yeah. People want to go into the stream. But the first thing you have to do is to get the mind absolutely calm. Yeah. If the mind doesn't get calm, you know, if you can't stay, you know, really at one object, you know, without getting deterred, you know, from the object. I mean, it cannot start the work of cutting down the fetters, yeah? And actually, you know, when you think about the stream, you know, entering the stream or going along the stream is cutting down the fetters that bind us to this realm, yeah? Or, you know, I mean, in worldly terms, you know, I mean, it's cutting down our attachment to the video games we constantly play.
And if you're not getting to the stream,
you can go in, yeah.
So there is any continue, if I do the work, like I do something,
yeah.
I get good, I get bad,
yeah.
And I didn't finish my work,
yeah.
Next slide, can I continue from the same point, or are you just going?
No. I mean, how can you lose things, you know, that you work for, yeah? I mean, you lose all the material things that you work for, but you don't lose the mental abilities, yeah? But you might forget it, you know, because, you know, I mean, the moment you go to sleep, yeah, the next morning other things, you know, pop up in your head and you forgot that yesterday, I mean, I meditated the whole day, but, you know, today I have all these urgent businesses to do, so I can't meditate. So, I mean, you can forget it, but the ability, you know, to go, you know, into calmness or to do investigation, that will stay. It's just like a foreign language that you learn, yeah? I mean, even though you don't speak it for 30 years, the moment, you know, I mean, you learn it again, it will come up very quickly, yeah? So don't worry about that, yeah? No, the work that we do here, it is the most valuable work that we do because we train the citta, yeah? And this training, yeah? Unless, you know, I mean, for the next 10,000 lives you don't do it, yeah? Then it becomes very, you know, very minor and goes in the background. But that work will not, it will have its results, yeah? And you will have the ability to, you know, to catch on very quickly in the next life, yeah? But some people forget it, yeah? What is Andrea? No? You look so depressed. Yeah?
Is this in the union or in the Höhen zu kommen?
Sprich ein bisschen lauter. Ich hab wirklich Probleme hier.
Ja, ist es in die Himmel oder in die Höhen zu kommen? Also ist es, wenn man jetzt so ein normales Leben lebt, wie man es so sieht um sich herum, ist es daher wahrscheinlich, dass viele
die meisten
in die schlechte Ebene oder,
ja.
Oder auf menschlicher Ebene.
Nein, die meisten, ne? Also, he just asked, you know, I mean, how likely is it for us to get down to the lower realms? It is very likely, yeah? I mean, even when you look at the Christian religion, you know, that teaches you, where Jesus said the masses are going through the broad door that leads to destruction, or through the broad gate that leads to destruction. The Lord Buddha said it very clearly when he was asked, how many people are going to hell? How many people are going to heaven? Then he pointed out, do you see that bull over there? How many horns does he have? Yeah, these are the people who go to heaven or to Nibbana. And how many hairs does he have on his fur? These are the people who go to hell.
And how many hairs is for people?
Wie viele Haare er auf seinem Fell hat. So viele bleiben, so viele gehen in die Hölle.
Wie viele bleiben Menschen im Verhältnis dazu?
Normalerweise kaum jemand. Normally, I mean, we don't get reborn as human beings. The Lord Buddha said in this respect, it is very difficult to get a human life. There are 31 realms of existence, yeah? It's very difficult to get a human life, yeah? When you get a human life, it is very difficult to find the true Dhamma, yeah? And when you find, you know, when you are a human being, find the true Dhamma, it is very difficult to meet a Buddha or an Arahant. So, I mean, if you have these three things, you know, if you met an Arahant, you know, if you, then you met the right Dhamma and you are a human being, I mean, you have fulfilled all of these three difficult things. Yeah? Most likely for us, you know, to go to the ghost realm or to the hell realm, yeah, that's where most of the people end up, yeah. And realize, I mean, that, you know, he also said, you know, there are four categories of human beings, yeah, or beings, yeah. And the biggest category, you know, is 70% of the human race, yeah, has no chance ever to get up. They have only one way to go down. And when you look at the world, you see it very clearly, yeah. 30%, yeah, or 29% are the people who sway, yeah? Who say, oh yeah, let's go to in the right direction, and then, you know, they see something and then fall back, you know? And then sway again, you know, fall back. These are the people who have the chance not to fall into hell, yeah? But they have to put some effort into it. And then there are two categories, you know, the people who just need somebody who points out the way and then they run along, yeah? And then there's a very minority, you know, who just needs to have the word, you know, that the gate is open, and then they are gone. Yeah. So there are the four different categories of people. And most of us are in the class of Neya. Because people who are not in the class of Neya, who sway, yeah, Neya means swaying forth and back, yeah, keeping the precepts, not keeping the precepts, and keeping it, and then not keeping it, and so on. These are the people who sway forth and back, yeah? If you're not in this class, you wouldn't be here. So, I mean, you find something interesting, you know, and then, I mean, your senses, you know, or your lust overcomes you, and then you say, oh, forget it, you know, I want to go after that. And then you see it, it doesn't bring anything, and then you go back, you know. And then, you know, oh, it is so hard work, you know, let's go back. You know? And that's the people who sway forth and back, yeah? So they will acquire some good karma, you know, in the times, you know, when they are really striving, you know, to keep the five precepts. Yeah, but in the, you know, the times, you know, when you know, just let go, you know, and go after their senses, they will also acquire some bad karma that leads you to hell. Yeah. So people, you know, I mean, people like us, you know, who are in this category, you know, who's swaying forth and back. Yeah, I mean, they will get some heavenly time and they will get some hell time. Yeah? Just like my master said, you know, then I was in this heaven, you know, experienced the fruit of this kind of good karma, and then after that heaven, I mean, he fell straight down to hell to experience bad karma that he has done, you know, in one of his previous lives. And then he was back up in heaven, you know, and then falling down to hell again, yeah. I don't know for how long, maybe it was just a few months, maybe just a few years, yeah. But, you know, going back forth, you know, going up and down, yeah, until he became back as a human being. Okay? It's not a very...
It's better than having 500 lives as dog.
What? It's better than having 500 lives?
As a dog.
As a dog. I mean, as a dog, 500 lives as an animal, it is very little. Yeah? It is very little. I mean, coming back from the animal realm, and you only get into the animal realm, not, well, maybe sometimes, you know, because you behave like an animal, but most of the time because you kill animals. So, I mean, hunters are very likely to get, to be born as the game that they hunted. And that is very dangerous because, I mean, even if the animal realm, the karma still persists, you know. If you kill another animal, I mean, that is bad karma, yeah. So animals who live on other animals, you know, I mean, they will go down and down and down in the spiral down until they become an animal that doesn't feed on other animals. And then they slowly go up, yeah? That's why the Lord Buddha said, you know, I mean, coming back from the animal realm is just like a sea turtle, you know, diving up every 100 years in the ocean, and there's just one ring, one lifesaver. And when it goes through that lifesaver, then it becomes back as a human being. Yeah? Animals, I mean, really have a... You don't want to become an animal. Yeah? It is very, very difficult. I mean, it's much easier to get back from the hell realm or from the ghost realm than from the animal realm. Yeah? Yeah?
If you have the source and you don't follow them...
Yeah?
Also,
no. I mean, if you have good thoughts and you don't follow them, it doesn't create bad karma, but it doesn't create good karma. Yeah. But these kind, the more you proliferate in these kind of thoughts, not to create good karma, the more likely you're falling into the thoughts, you know, that create bad karma. So actually, what you want to do is, you have a thought of, you know, going against the five precepts, you know, replace it with a thought, yeah? For instance, a thought of, you know, stingy, I want this, you know? Then instead of, you know, I want this, you know, you give it, yeah? Just replace, you know, a negative thought with a positive thought, yeah? The thought itself is the karma, it's the karma of thought. But if an action follows on the thought, you know, then it's also bodily action. If it's a speech, then it's speech action. Without a thought, without an intention, you know, I mean, there's no speech action created, and there's no bodily action created. But there's a thought coming. Yeah? These kind of thoughts tend to come back to us. Yeah, and the more often we think them, the more often they come back to us. That's why we should eradicate them. Yeah, let them go. Yeah. But if there are no good thoughts, then we should invite them. Yeah? Just like we train with the Buddha, 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 it's just a thought. Yeah? I want to be good, I want to be good, you know, and you know, I mean, it will manifest. Oh, I want to be generous. Oh, I want to be, you know, I want to be respectful. Yeah? Even though we don't know what it means to be respectful, yeah, I mean, the heart knows what it means, yeah. So I mean, yeah, I'm sorry, but the prospect is not really that that uplifting. But there's one thing that is really uplifting: we can change it, and we can change it today. Yeah? Whatever happened in the past, I mean, we will pay our price. But if it's from now on, you know, if we just create good karma from now on, I mean, we will get lots of good back. Yeah. Sometimes I say, you know, I mean, if you have a glass of water, yeah, if the water, you know, if the glass of water, you know, there's just a little water and you put one spoon of salt in it, it is very salty. But if it's a huge glass and you put one spoon of it, it doesn't really matter, you know. So if you do one bad deed, you know, and have lots of good deeds, you know, around it, I mean, this bad deed really doesn't, you know, bring us down. But if there's lots of bad deeds and there's only one good deed, you know, I mean, it really brings us down and makes us actually doing much more bad deeds, yeah? You understand?
So it's sometimes very difficult to difference between what is good acting and bad acting. Like, for example, when you're speaking, you're peeing, and there are horns, and you don't know if you put them, if you have bad intention, you know?
Don't focus so much on ants, you know, focus on your speech, that is much more harmful, yeah? I mean, if you sweep the ants away, I mean, they will still live, you know, I mean, you can investigate it, yeah? I mean, they drop from trees down, you know, and they still, you know, I mean, they shake their head, even these geckos, yeah? When you see them, sometimes they drop, you know, from this height, you know, fall on the ground, and then they look like that, you know, and 2 minutes later, whoosh, they run away, yeah?
So sometimes they're dead.
Sometimes they're dead, but that's not coming through your sweeping. I mean, of course they are dead ants, you know, I mean, you know, ants, you know, just die like that, but it's not through sweeping, yeah? unless you hit the broom on top of them. Yeah. And at the moment, don't worry so much about it. You know, be careful, yeah? But don't worry about, you know, I mean, what we think and what we act, you know, and what we speak, you know, is much more important, yeah? I mean, I know, you know, I mean, there's an example, there's something, you know, I mean, I knew some of the Tibetan monks, you know, when they started to come to Europe, yeah? I mean, they were so careful, you know, not treading, you know, on any kind of arms, you know, constantly looking. But on the other hand, you know, they were, yeah, raping their fellow sisters. Huh? But we are so careful, you know, about these little things, yeah? So that's why big bad karma, you know, can creep in, because they think they are so good, you know? I'm careful, you know? But the moment something overtakes them, you know, they create really bad karma. Yeah? So look at the big things first, and then start to look at the smaller things, yeah? Okay?
Darf ich noch eine Frage stellen?
Ja?
Gestern, das letzte Mal haben wir über das Installieren von dem Growing. Und dass man bei Kudo mitkriegen soll,
ja?
Macht man das dann im Prinzip immer, dass man es mitkriegt? Oder wenn man zum Beispiel.
No, of course, always. Ja? I mean, it is, you know, knowing, you know, the Buddha or knowing the breath, it is important, you know, that develops our sati. And the more sati we have, the more clearly we see, yeah? So, I mean, it is important, you know, to constantly foster it, but you will see it, you know, after a while it becomes boring and you say, ah, you know, I'm with the Buddha, you know, it doesn't matter, yeah? That means, you know, I mean, you start to get lazy or disinterested, yeah? We really need to foster it, and in the beginning we sometimes really have to ask, how is the Buddha now? How is the breath now? Yeah? Just to get our attention, yeah? To wake up the sati, you know, because it's asleep, yeah? The sati is, yeah, I mean, when do people have sati, yeah? I mean, remember, you know, in your lives, you know, I mean, once in a while, you know, maybe once in 5 years, you know, you ask yourself, why am I doing this? And then instantly you forget it. That was a moment of sati. Yeah? Why am I doing this, you know? It did happen, you know, probably to every one of us, you know, once in a while that we wake up and say, what am I doing, you know? And then we fall into sleep again, you know, we push autopilot and then, you know, I'm in the trust.
Yeah, how to solve that, please.
Yeah, that's why we bring up this question, what am I doing now? How is the Buddha? How is the breath? That's why you have to bring up this question, yeah? to develop the sati, to get the sati to work. Yeah? Or sometimes, you know, when you see yourself walking from your kuti, where am I going? Why am I going there? Yeah? What is my intention? And then you can stop and walk back and then sit. Yeah? This is things, you know, I mean, this is the automatic, you know, it's the automatic things, you know, I mean, we just, a thought comes in and then we just go after it without realizing that, you know, there was a thought, you know, that tells us, ah, yeah, let's go to Namron, maybe there is something that I like, you know, or, you know, just let's do something else, you know, then meditate, yeah? And then we just get up, you know, we don't know why we get up, you know, and then in the middle, you know, in the middle of the walking, we notice, hey, what am I doing? I mean, this is something that we have really to invoke, yeah? It's not something that it comes naturally, yeah? And that's what we do in our practice when we observe the breath or when we observe the Buddha. How is the Buddha? How is the breath? Yeah? Yeah? I mean, do it in the beginning, you know, I mean, until it is evoked, then it becomes natural, yeah? But until it becomes natural, we still have to ask the question, yeah? Especially when you get up from sleep, yeah? From your meditation sleep. Why did I get up? Huh? What was happening? We don't know, you know, we just got up, yeah? Oh, it's an hour, you know, yeah? And that's, you know, that's what we have to prevent. Yeah? Okay? Understood? Yeah, Benny?
When I'm doing good or with the best.
Yeah?
Good or best good and for others.
Yeah.
But I find it, especially when walking meditation, when I do with mental repetition for the good or,
yeah?
And sometimes I lost it, and then I do it when I walk out, I say to myself.
Yes, but you shouldn't. I mean, you can do it sometimes, but if you see it becomes a habit, then stop it. Yeah, you shouldn't do it vocally. You should think it.
Think.
Yeah.
It's harder.
Yeah, it is harder. Yeah, and you know, I mean, if it helps, you know, in the beginning, you know, use any kind of, you know, use any kind of crutches that you can, you know, think of. But the moment this vocally, you know, saying Buddha. The moment you see it becomes a habit, stop. Because that's not what we want to do. We want to think it. We want to replace the thought. Yeah? Because you will see the same thing will happen even if you say Buddha, 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 Buddha. Then your thoughts are starting to grow out. Yeah.
I'm not talking. I use the thought to say.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But still, you know, I mean, use it carefully. Yeah, in the beginning. But if it becomes a habit, stop it. Yeah? Okay, what? What? Yes? Yeah. Ja, gut.
Tatsächlich eine Art von Befreiung.
Ja.
So super, ich muss nicht in mein übliches.
Ja. So, but what is the question?
The question is, jetzt empfinde ich dieses Guru zum Teil fast schon wie eine kälte Kraft.
Ja, that's okay. Ja, but don't, you know, I mean, don't go into feelings. That is dangerous. Yeah, yeah. Just stick with those things. Yeah. I mean, that's why. Marcus. Oh, I'm in pain. You came late, and you're still already in pain. It is a helping. You know, it you know invokes, you know, or evokes sati. Yeah. This question: how is the Buddha? How is the breath? Yeah. This brings up, you know, the sati or the clearness to come and arise. Yeah, the same thing is happening when we do walking meditation. At the end of the path, we just, you know, evoke the sati. Have I been with my Buddha or have I been with my breath? Huh? When, you know, what, you know, oh, I lost it already at the beginning. Okay, just this one path, I will be with the breath or with the Buddha. And then when I turn around, I ask the same question. Have I been all the time with my Buddha or all the time with my breath? No? Okay, just this one path. This also helps. But why don't we do it? Because we get lazy. Yeah? It's bothersome. The mind, you know, wants to, you know, lullil, you know, wants to, you know, be in a lullaby. Yeah? Yeah? That's why it is so difficult. And that, if something is difficult, that also means for us it is helpful. It is helpful to invoke the sati. Yeah? Okay, so use it, both on your walking path. I mean, I explained it before, you know, I mean, you should notice it, you should know it, when you turn around in the walking path. Na, ob du das Buddha verloren hast oder nicht.
Ja.
Ja, you're doing it. That's why, you know, when you turn around, you're not in the tralala. I mean, in order to be able to turn around, I mean, you have to have some sort of activity going on. And that's where you, yeah, also invoke this question. Yeah? That's why we don't walk in a circle. Yeah, that's why we walk up and down, you know, in order not to get in a tralala. Yeah, or in a lullaby. Yeah? It's the same thing, and you will see. It will help just the same way as when you ask yourself, how is the Buddha? Yeah, how is the breath? Yeah? Okay. So, enough for today. It's already late.
I have to combine walking fast and this checking.
I mean, you still turn around. Just ask yourself, have I been with the Buddha all the time? Just ask this, yeah? The more you become aware, you know exactly where it stopped. In the middle, or the beginning, or towards the end, yeah? But just ask this one question, not more, yeah? And don't think about it, yeah? Just realize, you know, I mean, because the moment you turn around, you know, I mean, I wasn't with my Buddha, I know it. No. I mean, it's just to evoke the sati, you know. I mean, was I with my Buddha, you know? And then, yeah, the second thought is, this one path, I just, you know, want to stick, yeah, to the breath of the Buddha. These two thoughts, yeah, not more. Yeah? Not thinking about when did I lose my Buddha, because then you run the next path, you know, and still thinking, when did I lose my Buddha on the last path, and you turn around and still thinking, and then it's all gone. No. Just these two thoughts. Yeah? Just to evoke, you know, I mean, to evoke this presence, huh, Michel? Yeah? These are all helpful means, you know, to evoke sati. And sati is the most important thing. And now I don't accept any more questions. Yeah?